Welcome to Office Essentials. If your organization is subject to requirements around where your data is stored, in the next few minutes, I'll walk you through Multi-Geo capabilities in Office 365. Multi-Geo is about data residency. You can control where your Office 365 data resides at rest or on a per-user basis for your mailbox and OneDrive content, or determine where you want to locate your shared resources like SharePoint sites based on where you need your data to be, all using a single Office 365 tenant. Now, these capabilities are especially important with the growing rise in regulatory requirements that place the onus on your organization to control the geographic location of where your data is stored so that it can be kept within specific regional boundaries. If you don't have a solution for this, you may feel less confident in expanding your business into new markets, distributing your workforce, or even moving to the cloud. Now, the traditional way to tackle data residency has been to manage people and resources who reside in different countries or regions within the organization as separate entities, even though you're all part of the same organization. Now, perhaps you have a distributed data center model that's using on-premises data centers aligned to geographic locations, or you find yourself maintaining an often complex hybrid architecture to offer Office 365 to users in a limited number of geographies just to address data compliance needs. Now, while this keeps your data potentially in the appropriate location, we know that these approaches can be really expensive and, worst of all, create data silos, also limiting collaboration on your organization's most important currency, information, which has a bigger impact in terms of constraining your organization's overall productivity and innovation. Now, the good news here is that there's now a better and more efficient way to solve for this challenge with Multi-Geo and Office 365, which works by allowing you to operate a single global Office 365 tenant and gives you the control to pinpoint in the locations around the world where each user's content is stored at rest and where future content will be stored. And because everyone's operating from within the same global tenant, users across geographies can work together seamlessly, regardless of their location. Now, everyone gets a unified set of experiences from scheduling meetings to unified search, file sharing, and much more, as well as easy access for mobile devices. And they don't have to do anything different, it just works. Now, for compliance officers, we give you visibility into where your data resides. And for IT, we give you extensive controls to fit your organization's specific data security and compliance needs at a global and regional level. Of course, probably the next question on your mind is the extent of Microsoft's global coverage. Microsoft operates in excess of 100 data centers, offering extensive network capacity to meet the service level performance needs of our millions of customers across the globe. Now, today we support multi-geo in 10 different geos, with more coming over time. A geo can be a region or a country. So for example, you can choose to store your data in regions like the European Union or Asia Pacific, or countries such as the United Kingdom and India. And beyond NGO data residency, each geo supports business continuity with the ability to fail over within that geo. And Microsoft won't move your data at rest outside of your selected geo unless you choose to move it. You can learn more and plan your data residency footprint by using our interactive map to determine the data residency geographies available to your organization. Okay, now let's switch gears to administering Multi-Geo for your organization. Now, the admin setup and management experience is reflective of the specific service that you're working with, whether that's OneDrive, Exchange, or SharePoint. Once enabled, adding a satellite geo for OneDrive and SharePoint is as simple as adding a location and choosing a namespace for that geo and assigning a unique URL prefix. To assign your users to satellite geos, the first thing you need to do is establish the preferred data location, or PDL, for your users. PDL is an Azure AD attribute that allows you to control where user data is stored at rest. You can assign a PDL in two different ways. If your organization currently uses Azure AD Connect, then you can synchronize the PDL with your on-premises Active Directory. Or you can use PowerShell with the Azure AD module to assign the PDL for a cloud identity that is not synced with a local Active Directory. And you can learn more at the link shown. Now, a few tips here. With Exchange Email, when you set a PDL on a new or existing user, it automatically moves their mailbox to the location specified. And with OneDrive, for new users, their OneDrive will be set to that location when they start using the service. And for existing OneDrive users, data moves are required, and those are configured using the PDL setting. And you can schedule the actual move using the start SPO user and content move commandlet, which is part of the SharePoint Online module, to move data between geos. Similarly, for SharePoint sites, you can use the start SPO site and content move commandlet to move your sites between geos. Now, you can learn more about these at the link shown. Now with Multi-Geo established, you can manage global and regional settings for your users and data within the Microsoft 365 Admin Center. For SharePoint and OneDrive, you can set unique Multi-Geo policies for each geo, such as, for example, to block sharing with external users within the UK using OneDrive, whereas maybe allowing external sharing in another geo, such as the US. Now you can tailor data loss prevention or DLP policies per geo for OneDrive, SharePoint, and Exchange. For example, here we're configuring DLP policies for my specific SharePoint sites. You can use the auditing capabilities in Office 365 to track all activities at a global level and much more. Then to track your multi-geo implementation, our reporting dashboard gives you a summary view of how many users are in each particular geo. One tip here, managing your data location needs for shared resources like SharePoint sites works based on where the owner of the site resides. So if I'm a user in the US who set up the site, data will be stored in the United States and the site and sharing policies for that geo will actually apply. And as a SharePoint service admin, I can assign site owner privileges to an individual in another location. Equally, I can have individuals from other geos be members of these sites and collaborate as one enterprise organization. Now, as I mentioned before, users don't have to do anything differently. The app launcher is multi-geo aware too. Users can share with colleagues from around the world with a global people picker, and they can see documents shared with them across regions globally in a single unified view. And documents they create and save are automatically stored in their regional OneDrive. Also, by going to SharePoint Home, users can easily follow news and updates from their favorite sites wherever they reside. So that was a quick overview of how Multi-Geo and Office 365 can help you manage your diverse organization-wide data residency needs. Now, as you've seen in our examples, your users can seamlessly work together regardless of their location and enjoy an uncompromised experience. And as an admin, you can more easily and confidently manage a distributed global workforce as your organization expands into new markets. Multi-geo capabilities for OneDrive, Exchange, and SharePoint are generally available now. For more information, check out the link shown, and thanks for watching.